con Bliss and Esso. How fun does this tour sound? So good to be getting back on the road.
We've got the Wheel on Stage, the Wheel of Tunes tour. Mm-hmm. So we're literally giving the fans the opportunity to win the song they want. You know, we've got all these cult classic songs we never get to play live, right?
Right.
So it's like giving the, you know, this opportunity to do something a little bit different, and they get to, you know, participate.
You were asking what Wheel of Tunes meant.
So this is what they come up on stage, and then you got to play it.
Yeah. So literally, we're running polls beforehand to find out what are all the songs they want to be on the wheel,
classics.
Right? Yeah. Because you know, when you do a tour, there's generally you got your big hits. That's what you get through. But there's all these cult classics like that the fans love.
And you want to reward them with the album track that they don't normally get to hear.
Yeah. People rock up with homemade merch for some of these, you know, songs, and you know, and so
they'll scream these names of the songs at us while we're doing the hit songs too. It's like, play this one!
Instead of screaming, they can now just spin a wheel. It's much more civilised.
That's right.
I get that. But is there anything on the wheel that if they spin, you'll be, oh, God, why did we put that on the wheel?
Do we have any cringeworthy old tracks?
I'll tell you what, we were rehearsing today, I'm not going to lie. So I was like, man, we got to have a listen to these songs because I forgot these lyrics. It's, there's definitely, we had to delve deep in the archives. The craziest thing is we got a big catalog.
Yeah.
So there's a lot in there. And it's really cool just to have all these songs. Like it took me back just listening back to them all. Do you know what I mean? Like, damn, man, that was some crazy stuff we were talking about.
Is there anything that you couldn't talk, like lyrics you did then that you wouldn't do now?
There's some definite ones that are like
some outlandish lyrics in there, but we're willing to do it. We're willing to go there.
I felt like there was maybe we won't know it. We're willing to do it. Okay, you guys can chat about that.
What happens if you forget the words to one of the songs?
We've been rehearsing.
That's the part where you just put the mic out. You go for it.
I think that works better for Bon Jovi than for rap.
Yeah.
Like, it's a lot of words.
You'll be surprised. Really? When we first started, the fans would sing the chorus with us, and we were like, oh, my God, that's amazing. And then after a while, they were saying every single lyric in the cadence and flow, and we were like, okay.
Yeah.
Right.
Dedication.
Because a lot of artists want to play their new stuff.
Yeah.
You know, why is it important to you guys to play the whole breadth of your catalogue?
Well, you know, we've been a band for so long, right? And we've got built up this amazing fan base. It's like a family, right? And so many of these songs mean something personal. It's like a part of the soundtrack to their lives, right? Yeah. And they don't get to see them live so many times. So this is like our tour to give back to them, right? But why not do it in a super fun way when we put it on the Wheel of Tunes, right? So we're going to, all these different competitions are going to get up. We're going to have shoey competitions, best tattoo, like all types of things to win, to get the chance to hit the button to get their song. And we'll see. We're going to see.
It's a game show.
That's exactly what it is. It's a game show with our music.
But every Wheel of Fortune, there's a booby prize. There's one that you spin, and if it comes up, it goes bam, bam.
Oh, no, we've got all the sound
effects. Oh, you've got a booby prize.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. What's the booby prize? Like you play Edelweiss or something?
You guys are credited in that kind of crew who were the coal face of Aussie hip-hop when it started.
Yeah.
What changes have you seen since that time when you guys were helping create this industry, really?
Man, well, we started where there was no social media, no Facebook, no nothing. We were on buses, trains, sleeping on couches.
Like the boxes, you know, like the old school.
Yeah, right.
The cassettes, mate.
Oh, how we used to record?
Yeah, absolutely.
Look, we had no YouTube, so there was no videos you could go to how do you rap, do you find the beat first.
Pre-internet, right?
So we had two ghetto blasters, and you could put an empty cassette tape in one, and then you'd have your instrumental beat tape in this one. And then you could push play and record on this.
And the speaker
speak
would
into
be the
speaker,
mic.
Yeah. Microphone. And then you push play on the beat. You've got the beat and the raps.
So
and our head's in the middle.
Primitive.
Yeah. Rapping.
And then in the background, Dad's mowing the lawns. You can hear him at the front.
Yeah. I came to school one day and I actually I tricked Esso into actually starting this rap thing. I you remember CNC Music Factory? That song had just come out, right? And it hadn't blown up here yet. I spat the verse from that song perfectly to him, like word for word.
He was like, do you know I can rap? And I'm like, no, I didn't. And he did. And I went, oh,
and
my God.
And I told him I wrote it, right? He was like, what? And he was like, he went home that night, and he was like, if this guy can do that, I'm going to go and write my own rhyme. So he went home and wrote a rhyme, came back to the school next day, and he spat his verse to me. Wow. And I was like, I lied to this guy, and he's just written a verse. So I went home, and I did the same thing. So we kind of tricked each other into doing it, and suddenly we were, like, rapping. It was crazy.
Do you remember the first line that you did back?
No, but I remember the first song we ever wrote.
Yeah,
it was Stop the War.
Yeah.
And the hook was, yeah, stop the war. Yeah, stop the war. We've come a long way.
The wheel of tunes. Stop the war. Stop the war.
It has to be on the wheel. Oh, yeah, it has to be on the wheel.
If you want to catch Bliss and Esso's Wheel of Tunes tour, head to our website. I promise they'll play that if you pick it on the wheel. Thanks so much for joining us, guys.